Peter Drucker states, management is doing things right. Leadership is doing the right things. This quote right here explains the Washington Redskins franchise in one sentence. Yes, Daniel Snyder is doing his job as an owner, but leading the Redskins to victory, that's another story. Scott Van Pelt, who is a native of Maryland, wrote a brilliant column in his One Big Thing segment. Why was it brilliant? I'm glad you asked. It was effective because you could articulate everything that he has written down without being confused or baffled. And the reason why it's great writing, because you can see the tears, the blood, the passion of everything he's written down. So even if you're not even a Redskins fan, or not even watch football, you can understand and feel exactly how us Redskins fans been feeling for a long time. Now here's an example of Mr. Van Pelt's dedication to great writing.
They still carry themselves like their brand is royalty. You're like Sears, something that once was. In what make-believe space do you exist where you convince yourself of some alternate reality?
Next, I'll present to you what I believe are 10 qualities to great sports writing. Welcome back, fans. This is the 10 qualities of a sports writer. Once again, it's definitely in my opinion. Number one, facts. No lies, no opinions. Each thing you write about has to be backed by some type of research. So when someone else goes to look for it, they'll see that what you're writing about is facts and you can't differentiate from that. Number two, passion. One way to show passion inside your writing is by bold words, underline, some type of exclamation point, even down to a question exclamation point, and even also capitalizing either the word or a sentence so it can show some type of emphasis on that idea. So when the reader reads it, he can see exactly that what you're writing about must really mean something. Number three, unbiased. Simply put, whatever you're writing about, you gotta do the good and the bad, the highs, the lows, some type of balance. You can't always write good things about a certain team, maybe because they're from your home state or your favorite team. You gotta be able to do both. That's just what a sports writer does. He has to tell from both sides of the equation. Number four, honest. Everything you write about, it has to be honest. You can't pretend it, you can't fake it. You have to face it headstrong and know that each thing you're writing about is coming from a truth aspect, no matter who it hurts. Number five, knowledge. You definitely gotta have knowledge into what you're writing about. You definitely gotta have knowledge into what you're saying, because you can't use a one player for a different team on a different sport and think that you know what you're talking about. A reader will look at it and literally crush it from right then and there. Number six, fearless. What I mean by fearless is you gotta be able to write about things that other sportscast writers don't want to talk about or don't want to write about. You're in the forefront of a lot, and readers not might look at it, even athletes gonna look at it, and you gotta be able to say, I don't care what you think, I'm gonna write about it, because it needs to be told. Number seven, relate. Relate basically means that you can write something and to the average fan they can understand it, even that to a person who doesn't even look at sports can understand it. That's the essence of a great sports broadcast writer. Everyone can understand it. And speaking about understanding, that's also number eight. Simply put, with this understanding, know who your target audience is. You can't write SAT words for somebody who may not understand it. You need to speak their language so they can understand what you're writing. Number nine, conversation. Gotta leave some type of open for debate. Gotta leave some type of opening for anything you want to talk about. Not just being direct. Have some type of words or phrases that will spark the mind out of somebody they want to discuss. And lastly, quality is number 10, not quantity. Gotta have some type of substance what you're writing about. Gotta be able to put the details into what you write about. Taking one story and making it bigger so everyone can see exactly what you're trying to get your point across. Scott Van Pelt showed all 10 qualities of sports writing, but I'm gonna focus on two, and they are passion and relate. You can find it relatable when he used the analogy of the Sears Mall. Now, many of us grew up in the Hampton Roads era, so we exactly know how the Sears Mall was. It was big and very popular. Now, it's reduced to call centers and job staff agencies. Next, you can find his passion after the Sears Mall comment with the name calling of the Redskins and offering the Redskins some reading literature. I would recommend anyone to view Scott Van Pelt's One Big Seven on the Washington Redskins. I'm Ricardo Hicks, telling you to never give up, never surrender.